you, ladies. Good morning to you. It's a pretty morning. Maybe weather's getting back where we want it now, and so we're glad you're here today. Inside and outside, we always have a good crowd outside as well, and it's always good to see you, you folks on the inside also. So we're glad you're here today. Let me share with you a couple of things. There'll be no services this Wednesday night because both schools are out on spring break, and so we'll not have services Wednesday night. So you can mark that down. Also, we're getting ready for the bunny hop for the cars. We need some more of you who have volunteered to use your trunk as we line up down through there. You can decorate it, and we'll hand out candy to the as the kids come along. Our men's ministry in the morning, and our ladies, of course, on Tuesday, on the 21st of this month, mark it on your calendar, we'll be having our young at heart. So there's a lot of stuff going on here as we move toward Easter. Our Easter music will be on Easter Sunday morning. Chad and I have gotten together, and I'm going to give him about 3/4 of the service, and I'll take a fourth of it, but I'll talk fast and cover a lot. And so it'll be a beautiful day on our Easter Sunday morning. I look forward to that. Just a couple Sundays away, so we're moving rapidly to warmer weather and all that stuff that's before us. But I'm glad that you're here today. In a few minutes, if we got kids, if they're not all gone, we're going to have children's church, okay? Some of our kids are probably away since it's spring break, but I'll see how many we got. Anyway, we'll have that in a few minutes after we do our hymns. All right, I'm glad that you're here today. Chad, would you come and lead us, please?
Let's all stand this morning. I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart as we stand.
I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. I will say this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice for he has made me glad. He has made me glad.
Our God is an awesome God.
Good morning, boys and girls. I've got something in my bag here, and I'm going to see if you can tell me what I got in this bag, and I'll give you a few hints, okay? It contains information. That help you any? It tells you about recent events that's happened in the community. Got a guess? Anybody? All right. Gives ball scores of your favorite team. Where do you see that? Newspaper. All right, Jonathan, I knew he'd get that. Okay. It informs us, don't it? That's what a newspaper does. So, I brought a newspaper. Now, I'll tell you something that you probably didn't know, okay? We have a guy here in the church. See this guy right here? That's Mark White. You know Mark White? He and Cecilia attend here. Now, he is the managing news editor of this paper. He writes columns and all that stuff, and that's what we get. When we get a paper, we get news on the front page. There'll be the most biggest things that's going on, and you read about them on other pages, continue to page, whatever, you know. But we get news, current events. We find out what's going on in our city that we live in and then across the state and in the world, actually. So there's a lot of information that that we have in our paper because it informs us. And there's cartoons there, too, isn't there? You always read the cartoons in the newspaper. So newspapers are very, very important. It tells us about the political sense as well, all that's going on with candidates as they run for office. You'll see their picture in there, you know, and their ads and all that stuff. And so there's an advantage, and actually they do something with the kids, and I can't remember exactly what it is a newspaper do to encourage you to read. Do you like to read? That's good. Reading is very, very good. You learn so much through reading. So always do that and read the paper, you know. Keep up with what's going on and around the world and all that stuff. And it informs us of what is happening. So that's where we get our information. So a newspaper basically has four functions. And that is to inform us, to let us know what's happening, okay? And to interpret the news for us, all that's going on. They write it down and where we can understand what it is. They provide a service. I get the weekly paper. That's what this is, the journal. I get it every week and just to find out what's going on in the world around us. And then it's also entertaining. There's always some people who write in little things, you know, and so there's entertainment in there and all kinds of stuff, so we should read the newspaper. But let me tell you about something else. Just as the newspaper proclaims these things to keep us informed, you know, there's something that we're supposed to proclaim too. We have a mandate in Matthew 28 that says that we're to share the gospel of Jesus Christ. We're to share that with the world, that Jesus Christ is alive. Here in a couple more weeks, we're going to celebrate Easter Sunday morning, and that is what about? It's about the resurrection, isn't it? About the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Jesus said in 3 days after they killed him that I'm going to rise again. And you know what he did? Exactly what he said. And now he's gone back to heaven, and one day he's going to come back again. That's the message that we have to share, that Jesus Christ is alive. A lot of religions, they worship a dead Savior. Their Savior's dead. He's no Savior. You know, that's just their religion. But our Savior is alive, and we worship Jesus Christ who loves us. He comes into our heart when we ask him to come in. He forgives our sins and works through our life, all through our life. That's the Savior that we have. So you see, just as a local newspaper or a Lexington Herald or the Courier Journal, whatever, have news to give and to tell, we have a story to tell too. And we need to do that in school, in your classroom places. Tell them that you love Jesus. Nothing wrong with that. Just tell them you love Jesus and say, I go to Sunday school. Invite them for Sunday school. Vacation Bible school coming up here soon. Invite them to come to Bible school, and we'll see maybe their life change forever as well. Okay? Thank you for coming down. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you, boys and girls. As we go to the Lord in prayer, let me direct your prayer thoughts this morning. Continue, if you would, to remember Herman Adams in your prayers, Glenn Baker, Jody Barton, Donna Creech, remember Miss Donna, Cheryl Dye, Lisa Estep, remember Miss Lisa, if you would, she needs prayers. Earl Fox, continue to lift him up, and Johnny and Pat as well. Harold Frederick, doing good now, we're certainly glad of that. Meredith Gaddis, remember Miss Meredith in your prayers. Lisa Gibson, Gene Gilbert, Mark Gray, Colin Harrell, I had lunch with him this past week, and he is doing better, doing much better. Each day is getting better for him, but he still needs for us to be praying for him. Danny Hembry, Jessica Hoskins, Patricia Kiesling, Lisa Keith, Donald Hammock, that's the son of Janice Willis. Some of you know Janice. Remember her, her son, if you would. He's been diagnosed with cancer. Larry Evans, Jane Maseko, Patty McCarg, Jean Pryor. Remember Miss Jean when you pray. Avery Perry, continue to lift up Avery. I'm going to go to see him this week. He's in the Barberville Nursing Home, and so remember, he's there just for rehab, so remember Avery in your prayers. Also, Sharon. Remember Miss Sharon, if you would. Eddie Pierce, Karen Prather, Norma Reeves, Frida Simpson's doing good now. We rejoice with that. Gail Sprinkles, Jamie and Jake Taylor, Margie Tate, Dickie Wilder. I just spoke with Dickie Wilder just a few minutes ago. And he said, I love Poplar Grove Baptist Church. He said that if it wasn't for the prayers of the people and the notes and the cards and all that you encouraged them, and he said, thank them for that. And he's now home after being in the hospital, had open heart surgery, and he seems to be doing good. He'll start therapy 3 days a week, and so we look forward to Dickie being able to return with us. And remember Janet as well. She's facing some surgery also. Dickie Ward, remember him in your prayers. Mickey Wilson, also certainly needs prayers. So in the hospital, of course, Dickie's out now, and Avery Perry are the two that we've been praying for. As a church family, there are several families we need to remember. I had a funeral service for Tamara Ramsey Hall Friday. Many of you know Tamara Hall Construction out there behind Walmart. She was part of that family. I've known her all of her life. And anyway, we had her service Friday. Remember her two boys and the family in prayer. Jimmy Cummins, of course, continue to remember Miss Eve Miller's family with the passing of her dad. They will be going to Texas this week for that service there. And then the Binge family, Becky Eubanks and Dalton and Derek both. That's Becky's dad and Dalton and Derek's grandfather. Many of you have known Mr. Benz through the years, just a strong Christian man, and his funeral was this past week. So continue to remember his family. Also, Ron Roslow has passed away. I didn't know it until late last night, actually, and some of you found out, I guess, like I did. And so I always check the obituaries every day in the local funeral homes, but this was in Barberville at Knox Funeral Home. His service was yesterday. So remember Judy, if you would, and the two girls and the grandkids in your prayer with the passing of Ron Roslow, who attended here several years ago. All right, let's take these needs and whatever needs you have today. And do you have a need today? You have a physical need, something you're dealing with, or maybe you have a spiritual need, something that you need to deal with, you know, maybe a decision that you've been thinking about making, a church membership or giving your life to Jesus Christ or whatever that decision is, maybe a call to service, you know, for him. God knows your need, and he wants to bless your life, and he wants to answer those needs in your life, and so you just look to him. That's what we do for our strength and our hope, because he's our only hope. So let's take your need, and then let's take these needs we've mentioned this morning. Let's just take them to him right now. Now, while I lead us in a word of prayer, I want you to pray with your need. Give your need to the Lord as well. So let's pray. Father, we thank you that we can pause in this service today, and we can just bring these needs right into your care, and that's what you want us to do. And sometimes we don't know how to pray. Sometimes we feel like that we shouldn't be praying for ourselves, but that's not the case at all. Father, you want us to bring all of our thoughts, our needs, the dealings that we work through life with and decisions we have to make and all this. You're interested in all those things about our life, and you want us to include you in those things. So we thank you for that. We just praise you for that. That's one of the ways that we worship you is through our prayers. So we come this morning, Father, lifting up a lot of people on our prayer ministry. There's a lot of needs. A lot of folks are going through some difficult days. Some people, praise the Lord, are recovering, just like Dickie and others, and they're getting better, and we thank you for that. And thank you for modern medicine. Thank you for wisdom that you give to man, that he can look at our needs and take care of those needs. But at you we give the praise for the healing, because you're the one that gives wisdom to them. So, Father, we come today as a church, corporately as a church body, lifting up all these needs into your throne room. We're praying this will move your hand, because that's what prayer does, and that you'll move your hand upon the lives of these that we mentioned, plus the many others that we have on our prayer ministry, that you know about every one of them. And for these who are gathered in this building this morning and outside in our parking lot today, we all have things we deal with in life. And some of those things bother us, and some things we'd like to get rid of and can't. But God, we know that all things are possible with you. So help us to believe that and understand that and just bring everything we have to you. Thank you for these young children here, Father, that you've blessed us with. And for those who are not here today, perhaps who are gone, we just pray that for their safety and protection upon them, and just see them grow in their height and to grow in the knowledge of you. And thank you for all of our people who work in Sunday school and Awana and all these ministries that are pointing our kids toward Jesus. We thank you for that, because then they want this Jesus in their heart when they hear about him. So may we always be ready to spread the word, and I pray this in Christ's name. Amen.
Amen. Let's all stand this morning. No one ever cared for me like Jesus, as we sing the first and the third stanza.
I would love to tell you what I think of Jesus, since I found him in a phrase so strong and true. Something that no other friend could do. Now I You are mine.